click the bell icon to get latest videos from Ekeeda.
Hello friends, today we are taking another problem on Clapeyron's three moment theorem, problem number 3. In that we are seeing continuous beam with fixed end. We have to see fixed end. Let's see in details. Now this is a question given to us, continuous beam with fixed end. This is our fixed end. A propped cantilever of span 4 meter carries a UDL of 5 kN per meter over the entire span. Calculate fixed end moments by using Clapeyron's theorem of 3 moment. Now this is not there, I have drawn by mistake. A, C and B. This is a diagram given to you. Now what you have to do, you have to apply the 3 moment theorem. Let's take the first step. As you have to write one note as a support is fixed support, now as a support is fixed support, therefore we have to use an imaginary span near the fixed end as shown in figure, like this. Since this is a overhanging part, it's a fixed beam, so we have to extend one part like this and name as A dash, and this distance is nothing but L0, means this L will be also L0, and extend this part because here at A there have some moment, final moment will there. That's why I'm just extend this part like as A dash. Okay, now after that let's start our first step. Our first step will be free bending moment. Okay, free bending moment. Now let's start. How will you write? We'll start like this. For span AB, bending moment at C will be, formula will be WL square upon 8, since it's a overall UDL. So 5 into 4 square upon 8, it will value will get 10 kN meter. Okay, only one beam is there, that's why 10 kN meter only. Now our next step will be free bending moment diagram. Now we have to draw a free bending moment diagram. Now how it will draw? We'll draw like this. This is A, this is A dash, and this one is B. So we'll convert into two parts and find the area. Okay, now area will be 2 by 3 into 4 into 10 is equal to 26.67. XL will be 2 meter, XR will be 2 meter. Okay, now here also area will be 0, L0 will be 0, length is also 0, area is also 0. Now let's move on to further. Third step will be apply 3 moment theorem. Third step will be apply moment three moment theorems. Now see, since it is a fixed one, we have to extend this part. We are span, first we have to apply a dash a and b. So you can write over here, for span a dash a B, since it is a three moment, we have to always remember three parts, A dash A and B. Now how will you write the formula? See, you've made the formula from here only. M A dash L1 plus 2 M A L1 plus L2 plus M B L2 plus 6 A1 X1 bar upon L1 plus 6 A2 x2 bar upon L2 equal to 0. This is a general equation of the Clapeyron's three moment theorem. After that we have to write as A dash is an imaginary span. Since a as a dash is an imaginary span, therefore m a dash will be 0 and l1 is always also 0. So it will come like this. See, this is m dash a will be 0, 0 plus 2 m a, l1 will be 0 plus l2 will be 4. Always remember, this is your l1 and this is your l2, okay. Plus mb will be 0 because it's extreme corner. Plus see, a1 x1 will be 0 because area 1 also 0 over here. Plus 6 into area will 2 will be 26.67 into 2 upon 4 equal to 0. This is 8 ma is equal to 80.01. while solving this, ma will get 80.01 divided by 8 is equal to minus 10 kilonewton meter, okay. Your ma will be minus 10 kilonewton meter. This is a final moment, end moments. Now after that, find the support. Now you find it. Now draw the bending moment diagram. After that, fourth step will be find reaction at support. Fourth step will be find reaction at support. Now we are finding reaction at support. So we have only one diagram. So draw the diagram first. This is anti-clock, is hogging because minus 10 kilonewton meter. This is your UDL, 5 kilonewton per meter. We have to find RA and RB. Now how will you find? Taking moment at A equal to 0 clockwise positive, what's the possibility will come? Minus RB into, this distance is 4 meter, minus RB into 4 plus 5 into 4 into 4 by 2, then minus 10, it is anti-clockwise, that's why minus is equal to 0. Here RB will become 7.5 kilonewton, 7.5 kilonewton. After that, summation Fy equal to 0 upward positive, RA minus 5 into 4 plus 7.5 equal to 0, therefore RA will be 12.5 kilonewton. Okay, now we have done with the support moment also. Now friends, our fifth step will be draw shear force diagram and bending moment diagram. Now how will you draw? First draw the simple beam which we have calculated. Seven point five kilonewton. Okay, this will 5 kilonewton per meter. Now we have to draw the SFD and BMD. Now see, since it is a UDL, so parabola curve for the bending moment 10 kilonewton meter, and we have find a final beam moment will be also 10. We'll draw like this. This is your bending moment diagram. This is your A, this is your A dash, and this is B. Okay, this is positive, this is negative. After that, draw the shear force diagram. This is 12.5 up, 7.5 down because it is UDL, that's why inclined straight line. Okay, this is plus and this is minus. This is A dash and B. This is 12.5 kilonewton. This is 7.5 kilonewton. This is SFD. Okay friends, now we have done with this problem number 3. I hope you understand this video. Share with your friends. Thank you.